according to Bill Shakespeare, it went something like, "Once more unto the breach, dear friends." Our equivalent, of course, "Once more at the Cape, dear friends." To that end, D-1 saw the lovely Daintree village once again infiltrated by smelly biker scum. And leading the aforementioned scum is this guy, Peter Brown, aka Brown Cow. Well, no one calls him Brown Cow except for me, so it'll have to do. While sinking his first 4x of the trip, Neil Parker had time to contemplate just what might lay ahead of him for someone with only 2 months of dirt experience. Well, apart from more 4x, that is. Another comparative novice returning to the dirt scene. Wayne had picked a good package in the DRZ400. Shame he wasn't so prudent about his travelling partners. And to prove you can't keep a good man down without concrete boots or lead weights, here's Whitey returning again for a second time on the Cape. Same bike, same dirt on the bike from last year too. Next we have a newbie to Brown Cow's package holidays. Berkey is by no way a novice. His WR450 was ready to crack from day one. Shame it took 4 days to do it. Aboard the biggest bike of the pack, a 990 Adventure, Dave Beat was a newcomer to the Cape and hungry to set a few stage records, set badges to red alert. When not flying through the bush on his KTM, Dave Homer Wright is an air mattress. Steward. Yes, and that was his stand, and no, he did not take it with him. Not by any means last, except for getting ready every day, we've got Goose. He's also your narrator and a thoroughly sterling chap. Since the 990 was with us, the badges would have it easy. So, can 8 guys, yeah, 8 people, count them, make it to the top without incident or accident or any dents at all? You're just gonna have to watch the videos to find out.